Hi there, this is the first in a series of videos on variation. Today we're going to talk about direct variation and kind of introduce the idea of variation, and then future videos we'll talk about the other types of variation that we have. So direct variation is where we're going to start. Direct variation is a situation in math where you have both variables in an equation increase or decrease together. So assumption is that there's two variables, generally x and a y, but not necessarily, but both variables increasing or decreasing at the same time. An indirect variation, or an inverse variation it's also called, is one variable gets bigger, the other decreases. Joint variation is when more than two variables are directly related. And combined variation is when a situation includes both inverse variation and either direct or joint variation. So let's talk about this idea of direct variation here. Some examples of things that are direct variations. Circumference is equal to pi times diameter is an example of a direct variation, because as the diameter increases on your circle, the circumference also increases. Okay, so as one increases, the other one increases. That's the idea of direct variation. If you think about blowing up a balloon, that is an idea of direct variation. The more air you blow into the balloon, the bigger it gets. To a point, obviously, there's some physical constrictions on that, but as the air goes in, that's one variable. The size of the balloon is the other variable. As more air goes in, the balloon gets bigger. So that would be an example of something that is directly related. Now, when we look a little bit more closely at this idea of direct variation, we find out a few things. We find that it is governed by this equation, y is equal to k times x. Now, direct variation is also called directly proportional, okay? And this equation, y is equal to k times x, should be somewhat familiar to you from other studies in algebra, like when you graphed lines. So y is equal to mx plus b, that sort of line. The difference between these things is that in a direct variation, your y-intercept is zero. Okay, so this y is equal to k times x plus b, the b is zero, so the y-intercept is zero. And this k, this is called the constant of variation, or constant of proportionality, is a different way of saying that. That is very much like the slope in an equation that you've worked with in the past. So working with something that is a constant a variation, constant of proportionality, if we know the y and the x, we are able to figure out the k. If we know actually any two of the things, we can figure out what the third one is. Now, sometimes this equation is going to be what you want to work with, depending on the situation and the way questions are worded. Sometimes it is going to be much easier to work with it with a proportion, okay? Because proportions are things that are directly related. As one goes up, the other one goes up. So you could set up your proportion if you know different points on your line. You can just set up y1 over x1. y2 over x2, and then solve your proportion from there in order to get the answer to the question at hand. So I think what we'll do is just kind of go through some examples of working with this equation and also solving some things with this proportion. So we've got the question. If y varies directly as x, so this is a key word that you're going to come across in your work, varies directly. When you see those words, varies directly, you know that the equation that you're shooting for is y is equal to k times x. Okay, so this particular problem asks us to find the constant of variation. So that means we have to find what k is. And once we find k, then we have to find the direct variation equation. So we have to find the y is equal to kx. But the first step is to find the k. And the situation is y is 28 when x is 8. So we can take those two things, plug them into our equation. So we have 28 is equal to k times 8. Divide each side by 8. And this will reduce to 7 over 2 is equal to k. Now, if we wanted to write it as a decimal, we could write it as 3.5 is equal to k also. Either of those is acceptable. So this is our value of k. And then the direct variation equation, we just put this k back into our original. And y is equal to 7 halves, that's our value of k, times x. And that is the equation. And now that we have our equation, we would be able to solve anything that we need if we know either the x or the y. We could solve for the rest of it. So another example, we've got the cost of land in New York is directly proportional. There's your key words again, directly proportional or directly related. This problem says varies directly, just different ways of saying that same thing. So it's directly proportional to the size of the land. If a 2,500 square foot piece of land costs $162,400, then what is the cost of a 3,200 square foot piece of land? So this problem, I'm going to show two different ways of doing it. First, let's use the equation y is equal to k times x. So we've got to use what we know in order to find our k. We know two pieces of information. We know the square foot of the land, square feet of the land, and we know the cost. So if we call the square feet x and the cost y, we could plug those into our equation. 162,400 is equal to 2,500 times k. Divide each side by 2,500. And I'm just going to do this on a calculator. And we will get 162,400 divided by 2,500, and we'll get 64.96 is our value of k. So we can now write our equation y is equal to 64.96 times x, substituting in the value of k into our direct relationship. And now we can solve our equation when we've got 3,200 square foot piece of land. We just have to substitute this in for our x. So y is equal to 64.96 times the 3,200 square feet. And again, I'll use my calculator, 64.96 times 3,200 equals 207,872. Put the dollar sign on this. So 207,872 is the value of our new piece of land. So that is solving this problem using this equation for a direct variation. Now, alternately, because it's directly proportional and they give us three of these pieces, we can call this x1, y1, x2, and then y2. is going to be our cost. Actually, I should probably put this over here. Whoops. Because the cost is going to be Y2. So we can set up our proportion, and it really doesn't matter if we go Y2 over X2, Y1 over X1, as long as we are consistent. So let's just go Y1 over X1, so 162,400 over X1, which is 2,500, is equal to Y2, which we don't know, over the land, which is 3,200 for our second piece of land. And now we can just solve our problem using cross products. And let me change colors on this. So we take 3,200 times the 162,000 that way. And when we get that, we get 162,400 times 3,200. So 51968. And there was four zeros after that. So that's 519,680,000. And then our other cross product here is going to be 2,500 times Y2. And we just finished this off. We divide both sides by 2,500. So we have our 519 million divided by 2,500. And we again get our 207,872. And personally, I think if they give us three of these pieces, I find it easier to use the proportion idea than to find the equation of direct variation. Honestly, it's kind of up to you which one you choose to use. I default back to using this proportion. That's just what I'm most comfortable with. I think it kind of makes the most sense for these type of problems. So I will come back and we will talk about indirect or inverse variation.